with the Melbourne International Comedy Festival All-Star Super Show.
Coverage of the ANZ Championship is brought to you by ANZ. The Northern Mystics and Waikato Bay of Plenty Magic face off for the match of round 12.
Oh, Anna Harrison!
The Magic took care of business against the Pulse last week, and with six wins on the run, they're looking like real contenders for the semis.
It had a little bit of everything, a hop, skip and a jump.
The Mystics had a first half scare against the Steel, but the injection of Catherine Larson had an immediate impact, notching their eighth win of the season.
This game has suddenly gone up a few notches.
Get ready for a classic North Island showdown right here on your home of netball, Sky Sport.
Trust Stadium in Auckland has been sold out for over a week in anticipation of this matchup between the Northern Mystics and the Waikato Bay of Plenty Magic. The Mystics are at the top of the table pushing for a home semi-final, while the resurgent Magic have won six in a row and are right in the hunt for a top four place. Good evening and welcome to Trust Stadium in Waitakere for this huge round 12 matchup between the Mystics and the Magic. It has been highly anticipated and this big crowd is coming in here. With me for it is Tanya Dalton. And Tanya, we can't really overstate the importance of this match.
Oh look, it is massive. I can't wait. I can't pick it. You've got a team, the Magic, lost the first four rounds. They've won the last six. They've got better and better in terms of form. The Mystics, they win this, they're on top of the table. The chance of them winning the minor premiership is huge, so God, I can't wait.
Well, let's have a look at some of the results that have gone so far in round 12, and there's been a couple of really important ones for the top four. The Vixens, another one-goal win over the Fever, a big win for the Thunderbirds over the Swifts. Mystics and Magic is our game tonight, rounding out with the Steel and Tactics tomorrow. Of course, the Firebirds and the Pulse with the bye. So what does it all do for the points table? Well, you can see the Northern Mystics have slipped down to third. If they win, they will go back up to the top. Waikato Bay of Plenty Magic in fifth. A win tonight for them will do very good things for their aspirations of making it into the top four. Well, Tanya, the Vixens having another one-goal win. That's their third. If they had lost those three, they'd be down in seventh. It's a very, very tight competition.
Oh, and we've talked about it since the start. You know, every game has meant so much for the Vixens. It all proves you've got to play to the final whistle. And, you know, a lot can come down to goal differential as well. So for these teams out here today, it's finishing it off and playing to that final whistle.
Well, there is a huge crowd coming in. As I said, they are already rocking out here. A big Mystics crowd it'll be. It is the matchup of the season from a New Zealand in perspective at the very least. Magic Mystics coming up soon. Stick with us on Sky. Trust Stadium is building towards capacity for a huge matchup between the Mystics and the Magic. Both of these sides chock full of silver ferns, both sides in winning form, and one of them, the Magic, who simply must maintain that winning form to stay in the hunt for the semi-finals. Who do you think is going to make it into the semi-finals? Join us at facebook.com/SkySportNetball. Tell us who you think might make it. Tanya Dalton, have you made your top four selections yet? Who do you think is going to get there?
Oh, it's pretty hard, but I'm picking both these two teams will make it through. There it is.
Big call made already. Well, let's get into the starting lineups for these sides, starting with the Magic starting seven.
Yeah, and Coach Nolene Tarua, she's sticking to her tried and true. Irene van Dyke turns 40 this week. She starts at goal shoot, teaming up with Juliana Naupu, who's certainly been in some sensational form for this season. In the middle, well, wing attack Kara Watts. Laura Langman leads in the middle. And then Elias Shadrock, the young 21-year-old, at wing defence. There it is, the defensive duo, Williams and De Bruyne. Doesn't get much better than that in terms of athletic ability and height. So big job for them. Off the bench, Tarua probably could go for the likes of a Jess Tookie. And speaking of Tarua, she's now sidelined with Jenny Woods.
Nolene, we all know the significance of this game. What's been your focus during the week?
I know it's sounding like a broken record, but it's ourselves against ourselves, looking to be better than the previous week.
And look, a special someone's 40th on Thursday. What have you got planned for training?
Got a bit of a birthday cake happening next Wednesday. Not only is it her birthday, but also Casey May's on Tuesday. So it's a big, big treat for both of them.
Well, we're looking forward to a great game tonight. Enjoy it.
Thank you.
40 years of age, Tanya Dalton. She is an iron woman of the sport, and she keeps getting better, Irene Tunday.
Oh, look, I can't rave enough about this lady. She's always got a smile on her jaw, but the way she's playing, this season she's shooting at 95%. She's had a couple of 100% games. Her movement, her timing in that circle has been nothing but sensational. And, you know, she's such a team person. So at 40, I'd be pretty happy with my form.
Well, at the complete opposite end of her career and some 20-odd years younger, as extraordinary as Elias Shadrock, who was in and out of the side a little bit, but is really making a name for herself now at wing defence.
Yeah, look, at the start of the season, she got the odd bit of court time. She looked a bit shy out there. She has pretty much taken this wing defence position and owned it over the last six games. And I admire the confidence that Nolene Tarua has in this young kid, because she has got better and better, and she's got a big job tonight, I bet.
Extraordinary, really, that she can be 20 years younger almost than one of her teammates. Well, Mystics coach Debbie Fuller made a bit of a surprise last week by starting Catherine Latu off the bench. Will she do so again this week? Let's see the Mystics starting seven.
Oh, Deb Fuller, I'm sure she wants this one. She wants it bad, and she needs the likes of Kat Latu in there at goal shoot. And Maria Tutaia, she needs to fire tonight. In the midcourt, well, there it is, Tema Parajor. She's been outstanding at wing attack. Jade Clark has owned that centre position. And then Charlotte Kite in at wing defence. And in the defensive circle, Anna Harrison teams up with Kayla Cullen. Two very exciting defenders. And whether we see the old lift will be interesting. Off the bench, look, Fuller has played all these players. But one that certainly could come on is the likes of Grace Rasmussen. We know what she can do. Deb Fuller is now sidelined with Jenny Woods.
Debbie, you beat the Magic by six goals way back in round two, but this is a different Magic side, isn't it?
It surely is. We're not expecting the same team to come out that came out in round two. So they've grown a lot as a group. They've been resilient to a lot of pressure, so it's going to be a different team.
Also, we all know this game is essential to your chances of taking the minor premiership. How, in words, how important to get that home court for the major semi-final?
It is immensely important. We've really got to nail the game. 60 minutes of consistency and we'll be okay.
Well, you've got a massive crowd here tonight behind you. Enjoy the game.
They're great. Thank you.
Tema Parajor, the captain of the Mystics. In her last season, we never pick her out. We never highlight her because we expect that she's just going to go out and do the job. But in her last season, again, very, very good, improving all the time.
Yeah, we expect her to do the job because she consistently performs out there. She's a real general. She takes charge down that attacking end. She's shuffled herself to wing attack this season. Her delivery of the ball, the way she gives the shooters, you know, the confidence to put it up is outstanding. And, you know, she'll want to go out on a bang tonight.
Her midcourt partner is Jade Clark, the England captain, and she's made herself indispensable now to this Mystic side.
Yeah, look, Jade Clark got bits and pieces of court time early on in the season. Now when we look at this, you know, top seven, she has established herself as the centre for the Mystics. She's not only, you know, consistent on attack, but defensively, she gets some really, really good ball, and I love the combination with her and Tema Parajorge.
All right then, Tanya, put it on the line then. What wins it tonight for who?
That's a biggie. I think Mystics, if they can play with this at seven and they pull it out, they'll go all the way. And this crowd, look at it, they're humming.
It is an enormous crowd here at Trust Stadium. They are rocking, they are dressed up, they've got the pom-poms and everything. Mystics Magic, it is the game of the season in the ANZ Championship.
It's my side against the Mystics, coming up after the break on Sky Sport.
But this game feels like a final. It's New Zealand's best, the Northern Mystics, at home to the Waikato Bay of Plenty Magic. Welcome to the Trust Stadium Arena. And the Mystics, there's Anna Harrison, one of them. They want a home semi-final. The Magic simply want to make the top four. And in this ANZ Championship of 2012, that is no mean feat. And matchup galores from one end of the court to the other. For me, the pick is the clash between Maria Tutaia and Casey Williams. Tanya Dalton, who are you going to be watching?
Oh, I look through the lineups and there's clashes throughout, but the big one for me is probably 21-year-old Elia Shadrock. She's up against the master in Gemma Farah-George. She's got to cut down Gemma Farah-George. She's the main feeder in terms of into the circle. You cut her down, it makes it difficult for those shooters.
And this game has been so beautifully set up. The Northern Mystics coming in, 5 wins on the trot. The Magic, six wins on the trot. And look at Catherine Latu there. She just looks imperious.
Yeah, and just watching both teams go through their warm-ups, very clinical, no drop balls, all got a smile on their face. There's an element of excitement here. Look at this crowd. It's amazing, you know, capacity crowd. It does not get much better than this in terms of watching live netball.
Yep, the crowd apparently over 4,200, and I can tell you a fair swag of them are not from Auckland or Northland. They're from Waikato or the Bay of Plenty, and they've come in droves to support their side. And that's who they're up against, the Blue supporters, including apparently the Mayor Len Brown is in the house. And there's one brave Waikato supporter. So you might even hear a few cowbells tonight at the Trust Stadium Arena. The Magic so desperately need this win. They have 2 more games to come after this one. They know the position they're in. And they will be going flat out tonight to turn around that loss to the Mystics back in round two. But Tanya, they're a different team, aren't they, to that team?
Oh, without doubt. And, you know, they've just got better and better. Both teams really need to fire for 60 minutes tonight. And this lady here, she is a huge part of the Magic, Irene van Dyk. 40 this week she turns. Inspirational.
So that is the very settled seven that Nolene Taurua has been running really for the last probably 4 or 5 games now, and they've worked for it, haven't they?
Yeah, well, she was sort of playing around with their lineup early on. She came to the seven. They have worked for them. And I guess down the other end for the Mystics, Deb Fuller's more toyed around even consistently, even last year.
Almost tried not to look. Umpires tonight, Mandy Nottingham and John O'Brien, and Faye Meagle-John in reserve should she be needed. And there's little Alexi McCormick. She'll be delivering the ball tonight. The ball is almost, I think, going to be bigger than her. But look at these matchups. That's one to watch. Van Dyk, Harrison, Williams, Tutaia, all Silver Fern teammates. Gemma Farah-George already having a lot of a chat with Laura Langman. Oh. What a shame those two are marking each other.
Look at that. A late night for her tonight, eh? Big moment.
Magic first pass. Underway in this epic between the Magic and the Mystics.
And already having to go back to the transverse just shows how tight this defence is. Charlotte Pite.
Just as quickly, the favours returned by Langman. Tanya, is this a promise of things to come?
Oh, I feel nervous just watching. It's only what, in the first minute.
Langman waiting for Nauti. Yeah, Nauti straight into the back of Kayla Cullen. And that's an interesting clash, isn't it? Cullen, Nauti, these two young guns.
Look at the speed already. George just pass cut, working it onto the circle edge.
It's a long shot for Latu. Oh, but it's a good one. Oh,
beautiful dodge, Latu. And George, she knew she was going to do it. One and two in. Great start for the home side. Thumbs up from the captain. A few bodies on the floor already. Juliana Naudu each week has a little bit more strapping on that leg. As always, a big smile on the face of Van Dijk. And Naudu, she's always happy to put it up. First option is to go to goal. Playing it around, patient. Kaya Watts having to wait, and she's rewarded. And Van Dijk with her first shot, she'll be happy to get that one. Yeah, and that's the one they're setting up for, Williams and De Bruyne. So well done there.
No, Uku simply jogging slowly back into the circle. No rush. Take a look at this.
Yeah. Backing each other up beautifully.
So back on even par. Great defence from the Mystics. Outstretched arms everywhere. McCall going against, I'm not sure exactly who.
No.
Might have been an offside call.
Yeah, offside, yep, it was. And well done, Chevrolet there, putting pressure on that pass.
And Williams going high again. Great pass from Latu.
Yeah, so much strength on that pass. Oh, too tired. Yeah. I read about her saying when she's in the zone, there's nothing better. That's magic. What they need tonight, isn't it?
And the magic being put under all sorts of pressure on that centre pass. And in fact, on every pass. That worked nicely for the magic.
Amazing just how both teams are using their defenders on the transverse line. It's just so tough to get that ball into the circles.
And the crowd likes it. These two sides are the most accurate in the ANZ Championship. Thanks in no small margin to the work of Irene van Dijk and particularly Catherine Latu. All round so far. 6 minutes gone, first quarter. Nice hands from Jade Clark.
De Bruyne getting a little telling off there, I think.
Lovely is soft hands from the English captain. Mystics tight one-on-one, having a crack at everything. You could see the Magic shooters all been drawn right at one stage. But the Magic, they battle. Inside the fourth, so three times inside the circle for the Mystics. No guessing what she'll do. That one not falling for Tutaia. Halfway mark, first quarter. A chance for the Magic to level. Defenders drop back, gave room for Naoko to come in. And I guess, is that the threat that Irene van Dijk poses? What do you do? You leave her alone or do you go back on it, leaving the other shooter free?
That's right. And Naoko, she certainly has been consistent throughout this season. She's got better and better.
And you can't win games in this competition when you've only got one shooter. Magic in front, first time in the game, and scoring the last three goals. Unlucky, De Bruyne.
Yeah, they're certainly coming close to some of those. De Bruyne and Williams, they're making the Mystics feeders, had it to pass it wide, over the circle.
Well, this is what we'd hoped for. Nothing in it, eight all. Halfway first quarter. I think it's here.
Second or third time on the floor.
For Casey
Williams. Here, Coach Deb Fuller saying, stay on her rear, stay on her rear. So, obviously, a big part of the game plan is to hang tight on Casey Williams.
Yeah, Watts just caught Cullen with a head down. Awkward, really, for Williams, wasn't it? Right out of the circle. Off she goes. Back in now. Good pressure outside from the Mystics defenders. And Harrison and Cullen, just constant chatter, working together.
That
is a racket in there. You heard the word from Van Dijk, all yours, Jules. They talk a lot, those two.
Doesn't matter where she is in that circle to say, if she goes straight to the hoop.
I wonder how much they can see through those passes.
Look at this, a 3 foot mark over everything. Oh, Scarlett, so quick to that, no ball.
Yeah, you wonder why she used the bounce, Langman, when there was room over the top.
No, two says, you can do it, you're getting them in.
Oh, great work to Brain, forcing the held ball. just about had that.
And Langman flying through that midcourt.
Fabulous goal, Naoto. It would have been an interesting contact call, actually. It would have been interesting to know which way it would have gone.
Yeah.
One thing at a time.
This first quarter almost gone.
And again, Mystics having to go wide. It just shows the defence that the likes of Williams and De Bruyne are putting on. Forcing Mystics to do the big swings.
Watts in trouble, having to go sideways. They get away with it, the Magic.
Kaya
Watts has had an ever-improving season for the Magic. Cullen late. In fact, when these two teams played back in round two, the Magic used four players at wing defence. Deb Fuller, let's have another look at that. She wants another look at this.
Yeah, she's one of the best in the business, old Harrison, at deflecting that shot.
So, injury time. Ricky, is it Jade Clark?
Yeah, Jade Clark's called time. I think she's going to get ice on a finger that looks to be pointing in not quite the right direction, you would have to say. A lot of these players very heavily strapped up and all sorts of bandaging. But yeah, Clark just getting some work on that finger.
And Tana, I mean, that's probably a good indication of just how tight this game is. I mean, I guess most of these players are mates, so it's tough.
Oh, without doubt. But when you know when the starting whistle goes, there's no love lost. But let's have a listen to this.
Look, we are coming out here on the transverse line. Look to see what's coming in. That will dictate what line you go.
Yeah?
Your lines and angles are perfect.
Hey, pass D. Just 1 second. Hold it for 1 more second on Sarah Pass D because we're going to get one of those.
Timing, Tommy's just a wee bit. One goes, the other one comes, one goes.
As soon as she releases the ball.
So Maria Tutaia, she has had a strong start to this game.
Oh, Tutaia, 8 from 9, 89%. When you look at it, Lashu's only put up 2 shots, so she's done the bulk of the shooting. Her outside play is outstanding. She's obviously been told to work on that defence. She's marking Casey Williams all the way up to the line, and she's certainly what you call in the zone tonight.
Which is interesting, isn't it? Because Latu has been such a strike weapon, hasn't she, all season? She's shooting, what has she missed? 5 goals for the whole season, something like that. Incredible. So you see the Magic there, good to go. Langman ready and waiting. Here come the Mystics. Underway again in the first quarter, less than 2 minutes remaining. Magic, 12-10, just in front.
Oh, beautiful timing, Magic. Just played it around, Langman hit the circle edge.
And you have to wonder, Taylor, who might have drawn that penalty? She's quite halfway out for her.
Yep.
Thought, holy moly, I don't want to shoot from out there. I'll get a bit closer.
Yeah. She's played a few games in her lifetime, Jen, so...
Tutaia thought about the big one in.
And Latu, she hands up, she wants that one over the likes of Williams, but just shows the pressure being put on the ball coming in.
Latu is such an entertainer. And Maria Tutaia, such a shooter. Final minute, first quarter. 13-11 to the Magic.
Oh, again, yeah, better stuff from Magic. Playing it around patiently, waiting for it to open up. Mystics will want to score this with 40 seconds to go. Again, they're pushing the Mystics down into those pockets where they're causing the turnover for the Magic. So some really good defensive strategies there.
with those hands of Demi Putter George. She's called for the contact.
That's probably the easiest ball Van Dyke will get all night, standing under the hoop, no one on her.
They will want to be mega quick if they want to have another crack at it, or now they'll probably want to be mega slow. But they get the centre pass away as the whistle goes for the end of the first quarter. It was tight and it's tense, but at quarter time, it is the Magic just in front of the Mystics, 15-11.
Nothing short of outstanding, and every shooter who wants to be in this playing at this level needs to take a look at this lady.
And as we've commented, the most other thing about Tute is she looks always, doesn't look as though she's been running.
Yeah, well, you look at the centre passes, she's taken 5 in that first quarter out of 13. Her work rate's up.
Second quarter begins at the Trust Stadium Arena, 15-11. Magic in front. This game's so important for both sides.
Oh, William, she's always good on the rebound. Quick to that one.
And Tanya, I wonder if she's one of the differences tonight. You know, when we look back to round two, when the Mystics beat the Magic by 6, she was fresh back from surgery. She's a different player tonight.
Yeah, well, any player that comes back from surgery, it's going to take time. But she's certainly peaking at the right time for her side. And she's just such a competitor. She loves it.
That was almost a bit lucky, but it looked like it was sailing over the back, that shot. Oh, Kaya Watts does very well to somehow regather possession. Looked for all money like Charlotte Kite had won that. So a little bit of a run here for the Magic. Quite a twist from Tute here.
Yeah, but a nice hold from Latu. She always points with that hand. Shows where she wants the ball.
Oh, unfortunate. Kite had won the tip. But Shadrock was there to collect for the Magic. Jade Clark doing what she could to suck the penalty.
Yeah, and nice work now for pulling that in. Having to work hard for that.
Tutea just waits for Clark to come into the corner.
I still think it could go into Latu even earlier. She's holding up high. She's got room behind.
Nice draw by Kaya Watts. And the sort of, it's a twist and a split, isn't it, from Van Dyke? Don't try it at home.
It's a beautiful feeder.
Look at that guard on Watts. Auckland crowd baying for Hell Ball.
Defeat for longer, shot.
Debbie Fuller having plenty to say about it as well.
Again, the timing of Van Dyke popping through.
Oh, I'm not sure what happened there.
Yeah, she might have bumped the ball on someone's head. And as you were, says the umpire. An important turnover, and there it is, that vision again. You know Larcher's going to get up and pull those balls in.
I think it was just a fumble. Don't see it very often.
Contact wing return.
So now two in a row for the Mystics.
On the ball, both out.
Top of Latu.
Yeah, I thought Tutaya might flick it into Latu there.
Oh, there it is. Helen, how quick was that?
And she's renowned for that. So quick, away hand. You certainly can't get caught standing against all these defenders out here. You've got to take that extra step.
Shadrock doing enough just to stop that momentum from the Northern Mystics. And again, only that time that's being advanced.
No, it's when defense out of play. When defense out of play. Yep,
it's good.
Yep.
It's not like she can get involved in play. She's not allowed in the circle. Oh, there it is. And Van Dyke probably guilty of just, getting caught standing.
Mystics eating into this lead of the Magic. Just about guilty of the same offence.
Just such great defence out there. You know, we've been mixing it up, tight one-on-one, zone.
We can see the Magic defenders give each other a pat on the back for that one. So one way, then the next.
Oh, beautiful stuff, Watts. Ball carrying that onto the top of the circle. Easy feed.
Contact centre. Centre third. Centre.
So that rebound count heavily in favour of the Magic. Van Dyke, as always, seemingly having a great time. She said last week she couldn't wait for this game.
And Latu choosing to pass it back out. Well within her range, I think. She's such a beautiful shooter.
But the margin remains at three. Interesting little bounce pass from Watts. I'm not sure.
I think it was actually a fumble, but was picked up by her teammate, so that's what it's all about. Watts has impressed me tonight. She's done some good drives to the circle edge. She's feeding well, just really steady and calm.
Eight from 10 for Juliana Naupu. That was just a little bit. Was it desperate or just a miscommunication?
Yeah, well, it's a hard one. She had a hold on. I wonder whether Latu needs to start mixing it up rather than doing the hold against the likes of the brain, doing a bit more movement.
Well, perhaps Magic a little bit lucky there, just getting the contact call.
Yeah,
going their way.
Harrison gutted there, thought she may get the throw in.
Halfway mark, second. second quarter, Magic leading 22-17. Another one of those injury breaks, Ricky.
Yeah, it looks like Charlotte Kite has called it this time for the Mystics. Going to have a chat with the physio, but you'd think it's more about the 22-17 scoreline in the Magic's favour that rather than any major injury for Kite.
So there you can see the Mystics huddle. Kite getting a little bit of attention there. So here's a reminder for you where we're at. So Thunderbirds, massive win over the Swifts a little bit earlier, puts them up on top. Just a gaggle of teams, and the Magic knocking on the back door.
Are you no member of Lartes High? We've got to give away something. Don't you know, we're going to get that foot around. We're going to get around to push up. You know off Bubby,
sorry my dog.
You know off Bubby, she's actually swinging. The ball swings to here.
This is what lies ahead for the Magic. It's not easy, is it? The Thunderbirds next week, followed by the Firebirds.
You better listen to Nolene Tadua in there. She is in the moment. She knows her team are out there. They're capable of doing it. They're capable of winning the next few rounds. They've got to get through tonight, though.
And interesting, too, you know, you look at those games ahead for the Mystics, the Tactics next week, and then the Swifts. And I suppose in a weird kind of way, Mystics could do the Magic a big favour by dealing with the Swifts in that final round.
Certainly can. But I guess for these teams out here, what's going on out there?
Looks Ricky, like... here's the change.
Yeah, they are making the change, Jenny. So what is happening is Jess Moulds has come on at goal keep, and a Scarlet's moving into goal defence, Kayla Cullen to wing defence, and Kite has gone to the bench. Doesn't look to be too much of an injury concern. She has got a smile on her face, Kite, but it's just making the change, and there's the turnover.
Well, Jess Moulds will be thinking that's the best turnover she's ever had, so...
Less than 7 minutes remaining in the first half. 22-17 in favour of the Magic. Blythe Shadrock puts a hand up.
Tutaia just not having much luck with this hoop down this end.
Catherine Larty, solid as a rock. I don't know that she even jumped for that rebound. So there's how the Mystics are looking now. Jess Moulds, one of these young players in the Northern Mystics who's really come on this season.
Smart move from Tutaia there. Go low when you're up against the likes of Williams.
Straight away, they cut that lead to three.
Oh, that ball speed there. Makes it so hard for the defenders when the ball is fired through like that.
Yeah, Casey Williams realised there was nothing on any closer to her, so just fired it towards the shooting circle. Cullen on one foot.
Yeah, and here's the speed, that passing cut. George, she's the one that's going to break through.
The brain could see it, but just couldn't get round to get it. Now the pressure the other way.
Look at this tight one-on-one marking from the Mystics. Every player is on their own.
You always think that somehow it's so fortunate, isn't it?
Well, the smallest player in there, and who gets the rebound?
It comes back straight to her, like a zona string.
Oh, Latu, I sometimes think, why didn't she just turn and shoot that? It's so hard to find these shooters in here against Williams and DeBrain.
Oh, brilliant, Liana DeBrain. Absolutely outstanding. In fact, I thought it might almost have been held.
Yeah. Oh, Tina Parra. George, so close there, picking that one up.
Bit of a shove there from Kayla Cullen. She got the tip, regathered. No way through for the Magic. Williams grateful for her height with that ball. Yeah, that's too indecisive from Williams. She should have let that go.
That movement from George, just involved in every second pass. So the Mystics haven't been stuck in deep in the corners this quarter, so they've changed their game plan a bit.
They're going backwards at the moment, the Mystics.
Bring the fan.
This will help.
An interesting Tutoia. You know, most shooters try and get in closer to the hoop. She just stands there. Just give it to me now.
So a chance here for the Magic to regain that five-goal margin. They want to do it quickly.
Tutoia, she's really struggled with her shooting this quarter. Now shooting at 67%.
Mystics have done enough to slow that ball. No, time's being held. So, oh, they'll have a chance for one more. It's there. That's it. So the Magic have the last say in the first half here. And in fact, they go to the break with a five-goal lead, 27-22 over the home side. And that was a pretty good quarter for the Waikato Bay of Plenty Magic. As he said, his side trailing 27-22, and a bit of controversy at the end of that first half. That last goal that the Magic scored was actually after regulation time. The school bench apparently trying to get the attention of the umpires, but not able to. So there's a little sneaky one for the Magic. And we await what will promise to be a fabulous 30 minutes. And Tana change.
Yeah, Temafara George moves to centre. Grace Rasmussen is injected into the game on wing attack. So Jade Clark goes to the bench.
No changes for the Magic. Second half away. Magic leading the Mystics 27-22. And what a great battle to watch now at centre. Langman versus George.
Yeah, doesn't get much sweeter than that, does it? And interesting, you know, all these players out here, they've all got that intensity look about them, but they're enjoying it. And these are the games that you train hard for. These are the games you love, the big ones.
So let's go sideline now to Mystics assistance coach Gail Parata. And Gail, what's the message? Five down.
Well, for our attack, we need to get onto Circle Edge and do some feeds from there. It'll be much easier for us. We can look for a pop pass maybe into back to camp.
And Gail, a bit of a change in your lineup down the attack end. Grace comes on.
Yeah, we're just mixing it up a little bit. We'll have a look to see how this goes.
Okay, well, you go and enjoy it. Thanks.
Keep connected.
I guess we should have told her that the mayor was expecting a win by three.
No pressure.
Jade Clark now on the bench. that shot from Maria Tutaia.
And a crucial turnover. The Mystics to get back into this, they've just got to take these turnovers and then score from them.
Well, let's go down now and hear from Magic coach Nolene Toru. Noles, you're up, but how are you going to hang on to this lead? We'll just wait and see if there's no one. We'll check our communications with Nolene. Meantime, it's a good start for the Mystics, and now we've got a bit of a pause. So let's now go down to Nolene Toru and say, Nolene, well, you know, as I say, you had that lead. How are you going to hold on to it?
Just by doing exactly what we've been doing for the last couple of quarters, being patient with the ball and attacking it.
All your players are doing the job down there. Casey Williams and DeBrain, though, they're certainly putting some pressure on, especially in that last quarter, Noles.
Yeah, definitely. I think it's, you know, it's going to come down to why. It's a beautiful game from both teams, and, you know, it's the final execution of everything that we do.
Yeah. Well, you go and you enjoy.
Thank you.
And she's right, isn't she? A beautiful game from both teams, and you can see, we've commented on it already, how much the players are enjoying it.
Yeah. Just about to take each other out, but then they're smiling about it. So again, KO Watts, some of her ball delivery has been outstanding, I think.
This crowd of 4,200. Launch into this chant.
Yeah, nice popping the ball over Williams there to Taia. And a wall being put up by the Mystics, and look at that. Close to getting a turnover.
It must be so close to hell ball. Oh, lovely stretch by Mole, but no Utu, she's up to it. 14 from 18. Harrison coming up to help. Now it's the Mystics having trouble getting forward. Harrison using the ball to balance.
And look who pops up. George, she's so good again. Passing cut, hit the circle edge. If anyone's going to cut through that defensive end, she's the one. Mystics again, so close to held. You can tell they've been working on that centre pass defence.
Van Dyke, well out, hoping to help.
And that is a crucial rebound. She went missing in that second quarter. Mr. Fugo, look at her now. And look at that, the deflection.
Miss Van Dyke almost too close under the goal for the rebound. This will bring the Mystics within one. It's good. Last three goals going the way of the Mystics.
Again, tight defence. Beautiful take, Watts.
Yeah, she's having to do a lot of tidying up, KO Watts.
Oh, no, Utu on the charge.
Magic clinging on as the Mystics launch a bit of an assault.
And you see there Rasmussen putting up a screen for George. So she's got the clean runway to the circle edge.
Those supporters, I think they're probably holding their breath when Tutaia shoots. Jess Moulds tipping. Falls away of the Magic. Oh. delight on Juliana Nohupu's face. She's like, you go, girl.
Tutaia hanging wide, up court.
Combined defensive effort, which Tema Parra-George just about undid. Can the Magic capitalize? George, it just shows her experience, trying to milk whatever she can. And of course, we go on, don't we, about Irene van Dijk's age at 40. Tema Parra-George, a mid-quarter at 36,
yeah,
and still one of the best in the business. She'll be missed next year, if indeed this is her final season.
Yeah, pretty sad. But she's still certainly.
Well, it's van Dijk's first miss of the night, and it could have had a huge cost.
Beautiful timing.
So, watch this. The tip, the tap, and the take. But sadly for the Mystics, they haven't been able to score from it. Boxed over in a wee corner. The Magic centre pass to come. So at the moment, this Waikato Bay of Plenty side are weathering the storm.
Oh, look at that ball speed. Jess Moulds, she's doing a good job. She's getting her hands to a few of these balls.
And she had a great season.
Holdings, I'll keep that.
And is that again a little bit of experience from van Dijk?
Yep. Two naughty girls standing there, fiddling with their hair outside the headmaster's office.
So now that infringement by Langman advanced. Meantime, Tutaia carries on.
She's certainly coming back into it. 19 from 26. Latu still. She's only got 12 from 13. Tutaia doing the bulk.
Yes, and so often you think the percentages don't do Tutaia justice, do you? When you look, 73%.
I knew she'd do that. The rail queen.
And look at the Magic bench erupt. And I'm sure we will get another look at that. Oh, Langman having to stretch.
Oh, well done, Moulds, but just...
Yes, you've got to wonder how van Dijk got a hand on that. I should say.
Destruction goals of 20%. Both out.
Look at this. It wasn't exactly pretty. But effective. Well, the Mystics, they got back within two, didn't they? And it slipped away, so a turnover now that they'll need to sort out.
Finish it off.
And that makes me think of something I heard in an interview with her, that I think Irene's saying she has never ever got an intercept.
Oh. She's dying for one. It's hard to get as a shooter.
Well, she's done just about everything else, I suspect.
This mystic scene, you know, Latu needs to come out and get involved a little bit more, even if she comes out of the circle. Keep those defenders guessing.
What? Call for the contact.
A beautiful delivery.
That's what she does oh so well.
Well, you know, she's going to get up there and she's going to pull it in, Latu.
Those long limbs of Harrison all over Naupu. Oh, almost too casual from Naupu. Van Dijk has backed herself into nice rebounding position, but not required. So suddenly, just less than 2.5 minutes remaining in this third quarter. Four goals between these two sides. Langman ran out of court.
Good stuff, Langman. Having a look.
Good calling from George, letting Tutea know she was there. Or should I say Rasmussen?
Oh, Mole, she saw it. She's got to have a go at those.
So a particularly quick magic goal.
Oh, breaking, not a goodie. One of those turnovers that you just can't afford at this time. She's playing like a teenager out there. She's moving that circle with speed.
So they started this quarter with a 5-goal advantage, and they've worked their way back to that position.
It's hard to believe, Jenny. You and I were here in round two when these two teams played each other in this magic side. They were like a completely different team.
Yes, it was, as you say, just such a different side. Positions changing all over the place. Van Dijk, from memory, went off in the final quarter. She had a whack in the eye.
Beautiful hole and nice timing on that one. Watts knows where to put it.
Okay, Watts started that last game at wing defence, but now has made wing attack her position. Well, in the end, it has turned out to be a good quarter for the Waikato Bay of Plenty Magic. The Mystics started well, but have faded a little. It is three-quarter time. It is 41-35 in favour of the Magic.
You know? Yeah. Yeah. The girl's gonna play the
messages from Debbie Fuller and Nolene Tourua. Six goals in it.
And I guess when you crunch the numbers, the Mystics, they're back up into 80% for the shooting stats. But the rebounds, look at that, 7-2 in terms of their intercepts, much of a muchness, and turnovers very tight. So we have still got a game on our hands in this final quarter. And looking at the shooting stats, both the goal attacks, yep, in the 70s. And there it is, Van Dijk, the lady of the moment, 24 from 25, outstanding.
And you can see the concentration on these players' faces. They both know that the job is not yet done. Laura Langman gets the magic underway, fourth quarter.
Yeah, and the magic, they'll just want to play calm, play it easy, do the simple stuff well. The Mystics need to work hard for every turnover. So important here now to score from this. Oh, the big diagonal. And Latu coming out, and I think, so a rush of blood to the head. I think Latu does need to come out and get involved more. She's only shot 13 from 14. It's sort of the same old down this attacking end. So they've got to mix it up. Williams and DeBrain, too smart.
Oh, Watts locked away. No, he was free.
Again, Moulds. Yep, that away hand. Getting the deflection.
No, he's coming round to help. Doing a lovely feed. She outjumps all of them, Van Dijk. She probably should, she's taller.
Well, she hardly ever misses, so she probably doesn't get a lot of practice at rebounds, does she? But look at that there. And magic, you know, they're going at 8 rebounds to 2.
I read today her standing jump is 58 centimetres. I think I got to 3.
And just things falling a little bit apart down here for the attack end in this Mystic side.
And they certainly can't afford to. And you've got to wonder, Tanya, there's probably a little bit of excitement. Well, the excitement here is the magic almost make a total mess of that. But when we look at the scoreline, perhaps in Melbourne and Adelaide, netball fans over there, they won't be sorry to see the Mystics beaten if that is what happens.
Oh, that's where this competition has been just so good this season. And with a few rounds still to go, it is tight.
Jess Tookie likes it. She's had a funny old season, Jess Tookie. Was in the starting seven, then had an injury, moved around, played any number of positions. And now has spent the latter games on the bench. Yep, you can have that one back. It's too far away from the post for me. Yes. Good work, Mystics defenders.
Again, Temapara George showing her experience, looking over the mess to get that ball through the court. Better stuff from Latu, that pop on the third second. Just takes a bit of pressure off, keeps the
the defenders guessing.
Well, that's their first goal of the fourth quarter, and it took them 4 minutes.
Good rebounding position there from Latu.
Well, the second goal took a lot shorter. That's better from the Mystics. Rasmussen called.
Holding centre.
And now George.
Yeah, still trying to milk it, George. She'll go for anything.
Sneaky underhand pass from Langdon.
When the defense sets the structure.
Oh, well done. Terrific work on the edge of the circle.
If anyone's going to get a loose ball. She's loving it. Look at her.
And is this the sort of play that turns games?
Well, we've seen teams come back. Look at the Vixens. We've had three of them with a comeback.
Tons of time here for the Mystics.
Comes down to who wants it the most. The preparation's been done by all these teams. These players don't get much fitter. And good work, Lato. I'm glad she didn't turn around and pass that. She needs to sink some of these shots. She's a beautiful shooter. She's capable. She needs to get amongst it and mix it up with Tutaia rather than relying on Tutaia.
So they've cut the margin back to five.
Yeah, that's it. And that time Tutaia ran the base, opened it up for Latu.
And now it's just four goals. And Ricky, time.
Liana De Bruyne has called time for the Magic. Of course, the Mystics have now just scored the last four, and she's just grimacing a little bit. We know she has had some big problems with her calves throughout the competition, and just looking at the lower ankle, upper ankle rather, at the moment, and a bit of ice on the knee too for De Bruyne.
Picture this young goalkeeper who's done well, hasn't she, since she came on.
Yeah, and look, she's up against one of the world's best, and look at her, she's got a number of deflections. She's working well with the likes of Harrison, and you know, some of the, all it takes is a couple of them. She's got five deflections. They can be turned into goals, and they can win games, so well done to her.
Every crumb, every rebound. We're going to get one of those centre passes, okay?
Yeah.
From Debbie Fuller, we're going to get one of those centre passes, and boy, they've come close. There's the scores as we've progressed through this game. Magic getting them like the closest of margins, and straight away the Mystics strike.
And you heard Deb Fuller say to Timotara, we need two breaks. She goes straight to the captain, and look at what they've come up with. Again, Latu needs to get involved here.
Rasmussen with the tip.
And you also heard Deb Fuller say, get the ball back to the centre quickly. We haven't got time on our side, so.
Well, it's falling your way. It's falling your way. The Mystics have scored the last six goals. Halfway mark. Final quarter.
And
just how this game has turned. A couple of minutes ago, Magic looked like they were in the driver's seat.
Here's what happened.
Yeah.
Yep, the call's correct. Mystics on the charge.
Oh, a little bit of ball speed from Latu. Again, that wall being put on that centre pass. To Magic's credit, they come through on that third second.
What's under all sorts of attention from Carla?
Van Dyke.
I thought he called walk,
but no.
So the Magic have just stemmed that flow of Mystics goals, but can they keep the Mystics out? Tip off the edge of the circle. How big is that turnover?
That could be crucial. Look at Casey Williams on the charge, on attack.
On Tematara George, just not allowing Naupu to get through. Beautiful skill. Look at this. Naupu almost losing that. Told you the story there.
Again, Langman just so effective on that ball carry to the circle edge. And she won't miss that one.
That was a huge shot. The Waikato Magic bench looked to heavens. We're into the final 5 minutes. I don't know where the first 10 went of this quarter.
Yes!
4 goals, the difference.
Oh, Deb Fuller thinking, is that the centre pass we're going to get?
They're all boxed in.
Latu v. Williams.
And I think that's tired bodies.
Yeah, but it's about keeping your heads now. Still a long time to go, 4.5 minutes.
Okay. Oh, Tute, you're taking a bit of a chance there before the whistle had gone.
Instruction inside, goalkeeper.
This game has so delivered on its promise. It's a free pass, so the call was replay, so she can't shoot it.
Vantage contact.
Oh, and Latu, I thought, was there. Send it in. I guess at these times you don't want it when you're throwing one away.
Hold it. Hold it.
And Mystics will just want to get on with it and sink it.
Mystics pass to come.
This is crucial for the Mystics.
Oh, DeBrain went out.
George goes low. She knows what to do.
3.5 minutes to go. The Magic lead by two.
And this is, you cannot hear yourself think in the stadium.
It's capacity crowd here at the Trust Stadium Arena.
Here we go, Magic. Happy to play it around. George raising her hand.
Yeah, Tutaia came over and across. All the time, the clock is ticking.
And there it is, the experience of Van Dyke. That little top, out she comes. Cool as a cucumber.
Mystics quickly out of the blocks. Shedrock chasing everything. Lassie's got to pop out. She's got to do something.
It's the big call that the Magic wanted. Hell ball on the edge of the circle. Oh, that's dangerous. Debray hauls it in.
Denver George goes for a wander. And
there's a left.
Oh! That could be. And that, Tanya, sums up things for the Mystics at the moment.
They've had their opportunities, haven't they? The time is ticking.
It actually had no impact on the shot.
No.
Looks awkward.
Yeah.
She's saying, Cram, I'm quite an experienced lip reader.
Van Dyke gave her the word, just stand there. Well, she took that well. It's an option for a game plan, isn't it? Just stand there.
And Van Dyke just bullocking her way through, but the Mystics have got the ball, but it's going to be too late for the Northern Mystics. And this is a huge win for the Magic. 48-44. They so needed it.
Here we go. It's got to go in, and it's got to go in quick. Oh, beautiful shot to Taia. 27 from 36 tonight.
Centre pass to come. They'll want it quickly, as you say, Tanya.
Tutaia flying solo, that's the one.
She'll take her time, it's short. Who wins the race for the rebound? It's the Mystics. The Magic players lift their arms in joy. And Irene van Dyke gets an early birthday present, as does that woman, Casey Williams. It's her birthday on Tuesday. A huge win. What a disappointment for the Mystics.
Yeah, but the Magic, they came out, they were clinical, they were tough on defence, down the attack, they were smart. Van Dyke, no clue, doing their job. The feeders, one player to impress me.